also very critical at this point to mention this. Since the protests have taken place and the issues have been accepted, the time has come for the protests to stop, because government needs to have sufficient time, a clement environment to implement the demands of the protesters. We also need to have our economy to continue to go on. When you try to stop everybody from engaging in their lawful businesses, closing roads to markets and other economic places, we distract the economy of the country, and that is not the best way to go. If the issues had not been accepted, then there would have been genuine reasons to continue with demonstrations and protests. But since the issues have been accepted, we should give government time to implement the issues. And therefore, I'm taking this opportunity to appeal to our youth who are protesting that the protests have already yielded the desired results. First of all, they say end SARS. That was the beginning. SARS was ended not by the IGP. SARS was ended by the president himself. The president, President Muhammadu Buhari, made a statement, a presidential statement, and that would be the first time that any president will say end SARS. And SARS has ended. The other issues followed. The other issues are being addressed, and that's why we are here. So I believe the time has come for this protest to come to an end, to allow government to address the issues in a very short time. I also believe that other Nigerians have legitimate rights to go on their lawful businesses without let or hindrance, and we cannot have that when the roads are blocked. So we don't want a situation where there will be a degeneration of law and order because somebody is blocked and he feels he must have his way. So we believe that withdrawing from this process at this moment is the right thing to do. Meanwhile, give us the opportunity to deal with matters that we have as a government agreed to handle.
My name is Godwin Sunday Odor. I'm a member of Full Gospel Church of God. This is my daughter, Blessing Godwin Sunday. My first daughter is here, Mary Godwin Sunday. Then Abraham, my third child, that's Abraham Godwin Sunday. And this is the last born, that is the baby, Elijah Godwin Sunday. I had a very dark incident last year, Wednesday, September 2015. I was coming from church with my family. I was riding a tricycle motor known as Keke Marwa to Ijeku bus stop. On getting to Ijeku bus stop, I saw some group of policemen at the checkpoint. So as soon as I got to Ijeku bus stop, one of them brought out a gun to stop me, and now stop. I came out with my wife to ask the policeman what happened. One of them said he doesn't want to hear any story, that the one that carried gun, that I should give him 2,000 naira. I said, we are coming from church. I'm not a commercial vehicle. We are going home with my family, my wife, my four children. We went for a prayer program, and we're coming from there. That is at the hour of 9 and 10. I said, I don't have any money with me. We are going home. I'm going home with my family, my wife. So one of them now asked us to go. So as soon as me and my wife entered the Keke tricycle, about to start the engine, I now had a gunshot twice. So I thought that I was the only one the bullet met. Bullet now cut my right arm and pieces my lower jaw here. Then I now came down holding my jaw with the blood gushing out. That was when I heard my children shouting, "Mommy is dying, mommy is dying." And as soon as I heard that, I now went back to the inside the car. I saw my wife, my baby, falling down. And when I heard my wife, I discovered that the bullet pierced my wife from the right head of the right side of the brain and came out of the left side of the brain. So my wife died instantly. So, this I have my family, my four children. Then this me here. I was in Lut while I was doing operation. Then that's the incident that happened. This is the woman, Dr. Joke Edumakin, that handled my case. And the brother standing is my brother that been following me anywhere I go.
Why are you here today? What is the reason that brought you here?
The reason why I'm here today is because of the gunshots that day and these children watching their mother in the cool blood, dying instantly as a result of that bullet. That shock affected my first daughter here, affected her brain. Since that day, she has not been herself. She developed confusion several times. And as such, I'm confused. I need help from the Prophet TV Joshua and the good sympathizers. Please, can assist me. My wife, as I'm talking now, is still in the mortuary because I'm still taking treatment. I'm yet to recover from this injury. And I need financial assistance and also the healing for my daughter here.
So you say that your daughter...
Please, we are here because of this.
Okay,
thank you very much. Please. Sir. I work for C4I. Sir. Command and control. Sir. Yes. I'm telling you. No, that will change you. Why would you use your money buying uniform? You must change.
Yes.
You must change.
So, very critical at this point to mention this. Since the protest have taken place and the issues have been accepted, the time has come for the protest to stop, because government needs to have sufficient time, a clement environment to implement the demands of the protesters. We also need to have our economy to continue to go on. When you try to stop everybody from engaging in their lawful businesses, closing roads to markets and other economic places, we distract the economy of the country, and that is not the best way to go. If the issues had not been accepted, then there would have been genuine reasons to continue with demonstrations and protests. But since the issues have been accepted, we should give government time to implement the issues. And therefore, I'm taking this opportunity to appeal to our youth who are protesting that the protests have already yielded the desired results. First of all, they say end SARS. That was the beginning. SARS was ended not by the IGP. SARS was ended by the president himself. The president, President Muhammadu Buhari, made a statement, a presidential statement, and that would be the first time that any president will say end SARS. And SARS has ended. The other issues followed. The other issues are being addressed, and that's why we are here. So I believe the time has come for this protest to come to an end, to allow government to address the issues in a very short time. I also believe that other Nigerians have legitimate rights to go on their lawful businesses without let or hindrance. And we cannot have that when the roads are blocked. So we don't want a situation where there will be a degeneration of law and order because somebody is blocked and he feels he must have his way. So we believe that withdrawing from this process at this moment is the right thing to do. Meanwhile, give us the opportunity to deal with matters that we have, as a government, agreed to handle.